Less than a month after their return home, Wilbur received a letter from a man named Octave Chanute. Chanute was a brilliant engineer who had become very interested in flying. He had written a book describing all the early efforts at building flying machines. He and Wilbur had written many letters back and forth, trying to work through the many problems involved in flying. In his letter, Chanute invited Wilbur to give a speech to a conference of engineers, describing the Wright brothers' flying experiments. At first, Wilbur was going to turn down the offer. He had had no formal training as a scientist or engineer, and he had never spoken in front of a large group before. But his sister Catherine encouraged Wilbur to go through with it. Wilbur ended up giving his presentation to a large group of men and women, complete with slides showing photographs of their flying machines. Wilbur got a very positive response from the crowd, and he was encouraged. Also, in preparing the speech, Wilbur had been forced to look carefully at all the work he and Orville had done so far, and to rethink all the problems they had run into during the past few years. Wilbur thought back to when he had started. He had identified three problems to solve. Number one, how the wings should be shaped. Number two, how to propel the plane through the air. And number three, how to steer it. He had assumed that problem number one, the shape of wings, had already been solved. The great engineer Otto Lilienthal had worked for years on wing design. There were math formulas and tables and charts full of data from experiments. Everyone working on flying machines, including some great engineers, had taken it for granted that the proper shape of airplane wings was already known. But the Wright brothers wondered, what if they are wrong? What if the problem of wing shape has not been solved yet? So the Wright brothers came up with another great idea. They would build a wind machine, or wind tunnel, in their bicycle shop. They could blow a fan over little metal wings of many different shapes, measure the results, and see for themselves which wing shape worked the best. That way, they could test hundreds of different wing shapes right in their bicycle shop.